In this segment, we'll talk about how, if you make certain changes in the coefficient matrix, how they are related to the change in the solution vector, and we're going to do this through the norms of the matrices involved. We're not going to show the proof of the theorem, but we are going to talk about what it means. So let's suppose somebody gives you a set of equations like this, says, hey, A times X is equal to C. And then what you do is, in order to be able to figure out whether this particular set of equations is well-conditioned or ill-conditioned, which means that, hey, if I make a small change in my right-hand side or in my coefficient matrix, do I get small or large changes in my solution vector? What we're going to do is, in this case, we're going to change our coefficient matrix a little bit. And we'll call the new matrix to be A prime. And then we'll get a different solution for that, because if we're going to change the coefficient matrix, keep the right-hand side the same, if we change the coefficient matrix, surely we're going to get a different solution vector. Now, if we define our delta A matrix as the coefficient matrix which is changed minus the original coefficient matrix, and we define our delta X, which is the change in the solution vector, as the solution vector which we get here, and the solution vector which we get from the original set of equations. If we define that, then there's a theorem which relates the norms of some of these matrices. It's given as follows, that the norm of delta X divided by norm of X plus delta X is less than equal to a norm of A times norm of A inverse times norm of delta A divided by norm of A. So what we are basically saying here is that the relative change in the solution vector, and this is the relative change in the coefficient matrix in terms of the norm, so the relative change in the norm of the solution vector is related to the relative change in the coefficient matrix by this quantity right here. So what that basically means is that if you make a relative change in your coefficient matrix, the relative change in the solution vector can get amplified by as much as this number right here. It doesn't mean it's amplified by that number, but because there's a less than equal to sign here, that it can get amplified by as much as by this number here, which is simply the norm of A times the norm of A inverse. So the amplification factor which you're seeing there is the finding the norm of the coefficient matrix, taking its inverse, and then finding the norm of that, multiplying the two, you get norm of A times norm of A inverse. And this norm of A times norm of A inverse is actually defined as the condition number of the A matrix. Condition number. Of A. And it makes sense, because we were talking about well-conditioning, ill-conditioning system of equations, and if this is going to be the amplification factor for the relative change in the norm of the solution vector to the relative change in the coefficient matrix, then if this is the amplification factor, that is what's going to determine how much change is going to, how much that relative change is going to be. And that's why we call this quantity here to be the condition number of the matrix. And now how this is related to quantifying the relative change in the solution vector to the relative change in the coefficient matrix, we'll talk about in a different segment. And that's the end of this segment.